Facing your fears means you as a person are growing, and that basically you're going through a lot of different changes and different aspects in your life that's making you evolve. So therefore it is making you stronger, making you more of, like, I wouldn't say a better person, but someone that is capable of dealing with pressure easier, that's capable of dealing with, like, you know, all these crazy life circumstances that can come across you out of nowhere. I think that's a definitely a good life skill to have. Now, what I really wanted to dive deep into would definitely be into all the struggles that we have too. We have a lot of different struggles in our everyday lives because we're human beings, and, you know, that's a part of it when you have to go through trials and tribulations to, you know, really experience the whole entire process of life. Let's say you're afraid of sharks. Aren't we all? But you're very, very afraid to the point where it's actually affecting your life. Maybe you live in California, somewhere like Los Angeles, or if you even live in Florida, if not Hawaii, so on and so on, right? The location can totally matter what kind of fear that you have. So you're really, really afraid of sharks and starting to affect your life, the way that you travel. It doesn't matter, just because you go in the ocean, like, maybe you don't want to go on certain bridges and whatnot and be even, you know, close to the ocean where sharks are. At that point, especially due to location, you have to make a decision and choose. Are you going to get over your fear? Are you going to let it take over you? Or, you know, doing something about that? It's one of the illusions of fears, is that you can't do something about, you know, different fears that you have, or one fear that you have in general, is that there's no solution, but there is. Freaking out about stuff like sharks, I mean, that's kind of ridiculous when you think about it, because the whole entire ocean, 83% of that would be, you know, the midnight zone, which is all deep sea creatures. In the midnight zone, you see the creepiest fish ever, and I'm not sure if they're gonna attack you like a shark, but hey, it looks very vicious. I'm pretty sure some of them are, like, poisonous. If not, if you can see them, it's not a good thing, because you're going very, very low to the ocean, and if you're not having the proper equipment, that's scary enough. So you have the anglerfish, the one with that little light bulb or whatever in front of it, basically like a firefly, but like the fish version. So yeah, it has the little light bulb above it, and that's giving it light, and it's super, super vicious looking. Like, the eyes look so messed up, and the teeth are so sharp. I do not like that fish. And vampire squid. So it's just really creepy. A vampire squid? Why? I think there's, like, the goblin shark too. It all sounds crazy, like little monster names. But the creepiest thing by far is in a place full of pure darkness. How do you actually know what's there? Kind of like outer space. We don't know what's truly there, what is truly on Mars. But then again, we don't even know what's in our own ocean. But besides the ocean and Mars and all of that in between, literally, you have to think about, like, okay, let's say you're flying too. That would be another example. If you're flying, you're afraid of flying, and you're afraid of going in an airplane because you don't want to crash, or, you know, you don't like that. You just don't like being up that high. You know, it could be having to do with heights. So you don't like having to be up that high because you're afraid of heights. Therefore, being in an airplane is, you know, absolutely terrifying. But maybe your job, you know, you have to be constantly in an airplane to get to one place or the other, and you can't, you know, have a train or be on road trips. Being on a plane is actually one of the safest places to be in the world, yet people are so terrified from that because they think that, you know, all the bad things that can happen. But for instance, if you ever thought about it, think about the security that they have. It's like a massive amount of security from when you go in, from on the plane, I mean, everywhere, really. There is security. There's not really, like, I'd say security on the plane, but then again, you have people that are working, and you have, like, flight attendants and professionals that are really just looking out over the plane. So, you know, that's definitely a good thing. But, you know, before you even get on the plane, all the security that's there. So you should already feel good about that. Then, you know, another thing is the fact that, you know, you do have the flight attendants that are there that are literally pouring you, like, soda and giving you everything that you need. So obviously you're not gonna, like, you know, starve or be dehydrated or whatever. I guess that's not really, like, a normal fear that you would have with airplanes. But still, you know, you have everything that you need that's on this plane. And then the last thing is that you have all these people that are surrounded by you that'll act in an instinct if they know that something's wrong. So yeah, it's just like, you shouldn't be afraid of something like that, even though it's so high up in the air, even though it's like, it could be dangerous. Yeah, everything could go wrong, but people do this every single day. You have pilots that are going there every day, flying different airplanes, not every day, but you know, it's part of their job. They do that. Same with the flight attendant. So they're used to that. Don't you think they had fears of doing that at the beginning and they're really scared? I mean, seriously, imagine being a pilot the first time. You're probably going to be very anxious and have a lot of fear. Or if you're a flight attendant and it's like your first week, you're probably going to be, you know, full of fear. But as time goes by, they get over that. Like, to me, it would be like, okay, so if you're in a car or if you're in a bus or just anything, like a motorcycle, really, and you're on the streets and you're in that car or the motorcycle, whatever you're in, you can still get hurt from that. You can still crash. You can die. You can get in a severe accident, literally making you fly out of the car onto the ground. A lot of people die in car accidents, but the majority of people, they actually fear death from specific events. Murder is a bad way to go. It's literally the worst way to go. Besides, if you had like a shark that was eating you alive while you're drowning at the same time in the ocean. People are mostly afraid of murders because horror movies, they just overplay that stuff. I mean, constantly you'll see it on TV, online, everywhere, right? I mean, not literally everywhere, but you know what I mean. It's definitely available. So yeah, we have, you know, horror movies that have fit into our culture where everybody is watching it at some point in their life or not. And that would make someone, you know, kind of think, yeah, there are kind of, you know, a lot of serial killers in the world that are crazy and they have all these wicked stuff planned. And I mean, that's not entirely not true or anything. There are a lot of crazy people in this country and other countries. But the thing is, it's not like it is how they present it in like horror movies. You know, you're not gonna have every single cabin out in the woods have some creepy person or in the middle of the desert, whatnot. You know what I mean? Like stereotypes and having that. So I feel like once you go past the stereotypes, then yeah, of course, there's still a reality. But yeah, I could go on and on about a bunch of different fears that people have. I mean, seriously, there are so many of them that everybody, they have their own unique fears that they have based off of, you know, their upbringing and what they've experienced in life. So nobody really has the same fears. So it's not like that. Okay, so what have I said so far? You have sharks, you have like murder, flying planes and whatnot. And all of those three things, really, if you thought about it, it's not going to affect you if unless you want it to. If you want to get really worked up and really anxious about all three, I'd actually say number one with sharks. Yeah, of course, you don't want to go swimming in the middle of the ocean. But I mean, like, okay, if you want to just be in like shallow water or go in the ocean or whatever, like, don't freak out every single time and have to think that, you know, everything's gonna be the worst that it's gonna be, because then if you start doing that, you're really just gonna freak out over like every little thing. But anyways, besides that, they're all basically illusions that you're having of what fear is. So if you actually take away fear from your life, I know it sounds kind of difficult, if not impossible, but if you try as much as you can to take away different fears that you have out of your life or try to overcome different fears, then that's going to be a lot better, because then, you know, you're not going to be worried about that. You can go live your life and go above and beyond and do better, and not even do better, obviously, but, you know, maybe do more in life because you don't have something blocking you from doing certain things. Once you start letting all these illusions take over your mind and take over the way that you're going to act daily, that is not good. The fears, I think that they'll start building up if you start thinking about things, and yeah, you'll have more and more fears and it'll start, you know, being kind of like a crazy life to live because all of a sudden you're afraid of everything. Do you want to be afraid of everything? No. Life is dangerous. It is. It's dangerous. Like once you go out of your door, even from inside, but once you go out of your door, you have diseases, you can get ran over by, you know, a car. You know, you have the plane issue, there's, you know, crazy animals and everything. Really, if you start thinking about it, the world is pretty dangerous. But if, I mean, you have to live in this world, you have to have a good time. So why be afraid of everything? You don't know what's going to come your way. You don't know if anything will ever come your way. And maybe you're fortunate, lucky enough, and blessed enough that nothing will. like, it's good to actually have fears as well. So even though you don't want to have, like, your fears take over your life or make you not able to do something that you enjoy and you want to do, or, you know, have your message spread out that you want to spread out in the world and do that, right? So you want to still be able to do that, but you still want to fear things. You want to fear, you know, obviously hell and, you know, God and other stuff like that, and not be, I would say, too irresponsible, like try jumping around lava or whatever, or something super dangerous, or, you know, trying to pet a poisonous frog or whatever. Like, don't do anything like that. Don't go try to go slide down a waterfall. On that note, I'm gonna head out, but I'm gonna have another video coming very shortly. If you want to check out some of my other videos on my channel, you can check them out. There's a lot going on there, so I'll check you next time.